Don't ask, what can I get approved for at car dealers? When you ask what you can get approved for at car dealers, it's like walking up to a shark pond and asking the sharks, is this a good place to swim? Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, also known as the Homer Guy and author of Is That the Best You Can Do? This video brought to you by YouTube's best channel on car buying and selling, courtesy of the Homer Guy team and our super high intensity training for car buyers. If you like the Homer Guy videos, check out the merch shelf down below and you can get one of these cool shirts or hoodies like this one. Making early mistakes in your visit to a car dealership can set you up for disaster, and asking what you can get approved for is without a doubt a dead giveaway to a car salesman that he has just been introduced to a clueless car buyer. I might be offending you if you did this on your last car shopping mission, but this has to be on the top of the list of the dumbest things to ask at a car dealership, because you are admitting to being very ignorant about several key issues. Asking what you can get approved for tells the dealership you haven't done an ounce of homework and you have no clue what you're getting into. You think affordability is determined by monthly payments. You know very little about manipulation of interest rates and loan terms. You have no idea how the dealer makes money. You don't understand dealer fees and products. You don't even have a real car goal, and you think the finance office is your helpful friend. Well, you couldn't be more wrong. The dealer loves you for asking what you can get approved for. You just threw yourself down at the feet of the salesman asking for kindness and mercy, and you'll get neither. You're standing there with your proverbial pants down asking what's next. If anything I've said so far describes your last shopping experience, you better not go anywhere until you get schooled on why this question, what can I get approved for, will set you up for your worst financial nightmare at a car dealership. Back in just a moment, after a short message from the Homework Guy team.
If you're a first timer on the Homework Guy channel, consider subscribing and leaving us a comment below. Add hashtag the Homework Guy if you'd like a response directly from Kevin or one of the Homework Guy staff members. We're always glad to help our loyal followers, and the best part is, there's no charge. You can also email the team at info@thehomeworkguy.com with a specific question, or if you'd like a free contract review, just black out your personal information and send it to us. We'd love to hear from you. Just be aware that we do get a lot of requests, so just be patient while you wait for a response. Back to you, Kevin.
The customer who walks in the front door of the dealership asking, what can I get approved for, is known in the car business as the lay-down customer, clueless about the entire process, asks what's next, is ready to be led by the nose to the finish line at any cost, and that is exactly what's going to happen to you. You'll be led to the finish line, down the road in a new vehicle, with every cost possible. You left the door wide open to abundance of mistakes, and today I'm going to dive into a few of the highlights. Number one, you haven't done an ounce of homework and you have no idea what you're getting into. The buyer who throws themselves down at the dealership hoping for mercy has just walked into the most predatory sales environment on the planet and has loudly proclaimed to anyone listening, you didn't talk to your own bank or credit union about a car loan yet. You probably have a car outside that you'll trade and you have no idea what it's worth. You don't even know what kind of car you want. You are the newborn buffalo calf who walks up to a lion and asks, can you tell me where I could get something to eat around here? You are about to be lunch. Number two, you think affordability is determined by monthly payments. Without the dealer having to set you up or condition you to shift your focus off car price to car payments, you just opened the door wide open and said your first step is financing, and as long as the monthly payment works for you, you're ready to do business. Hallelujah. Number three, you know very little about interest rates and loan terms. You are asking to suffer the consequences of the best car loan manipulators on the planet. With a buffet of banks to work with who zero in on clueless car buyers, you'll be getting hosed on your interest rate and your loan term. They can add up to 2.5 points to your interest rate in most states, netting thousands more in profits off the deal. If you don't like a payment they come up with, they can just extend the terms and voila, payment magic. If you squawk too much about anything and try to put your foot down, they're just going to say, this is what we got you approved for. Number four, you have no idea how the dealer makes money. The fattest portion of income made by a dealership starts by pulling a customer into the dealer's world of finance. No person who understands how a dealer makes money will ever ask a dealership, what can I get approved for? The multi-million dollar facility you are sitting in was bought and paid for by car buyers just like you. People who had no idea how a dealership made money and threw themselves down at the feet of people who are trusted as much as a congressman and a telemarketer. Are you getting the picture? Finance is their number one moneymaker in a typical car dealership, and you just ask them to introduce you to the king of profits. Number five, you don't understand dealer fees and products. You are going to hear a presentation that starts with, "I have really good news for you." None of it's going to be good news. This statement will be followed by the very worst news that would make any seasoned car buyer immediately get up and leave the dealership. However, you're going to sit there and hear how lucky you are and qualify for this laundry list of fees and products. Your car deal is going to be so full of fees and extras, it would be hard to get it all on one document. If you give one bit of pushback, you'll immediately hear, "This is what the banker wants you to do," and you'll be led to think that your loan is suddenly in jeopardy because you're asking questions. Remember, you're the one who started this all off by asking, "What can I get approved for?" Our video on 11 fake fees, you'd better see it. You're going to get a ton of those fees. Our video on products you should avoid at a dealership, yep, you're going to get the menu there too. You don't even have to be sold. They know it. You asked what you could get approved for, and now they're licking their chops and telling you exactly what you got approved for. Number six, you don't have a real car goal. This is perhaps one of the most amazing parts of this. As I said earlier, you didn't even have a specific car in mind when you asked that question. When financing and loan payments become the focus of your car shopping journey, you're also asking them, "What kind of car do you want me to have?" You don't get to choose your own vehicle. Nope, they're going to put you into a car and say, "This is the vehicle that works for our banker." They're going to target vehicles their banker is likely to prefer or a vehicle they've been wanting to get rid of for a very, very long time. You're the guinea pig. You ask the dumb questions, you win the dumb prizes. You get to drive away in a vehicle that somebody else is choosing for you. Number seven, you think the finance office is your helpful friend. Here's the nice man who got you approved. That's what you're going to hear when you meet the finance officer. They'll likely add, "You're in very good hands with Bob. He's been doing this for a long time. I'll go out and get your car ready for you." This is exactly what you thought when you asked, "What could I get approved for?" in the very beginning. You thought you'd eventually get to meet this nice man if the dealer got you approved for something, whatever that is. The finance office won't have to do any arm twisting with you because you think you're simply hearing an explanation, the favor of a lifetime, as explained by Bob, the finance man, who got a very nice banker to approve you because he's your helpful friend and has been helping people all of his car dealership life. Everything he says to you is what's best for you and, of course, what the banker approved for you. You are sitting in the office of the king of profits and you think this is your helpful friend. You didn't see our video on how to beat the dealer finance office. In fact, you never knew that beating the finance office is something you were ever going to need to do. All right. If you ever walked into a dealership before and asked, "What can I get approved for?" I hope you'll never make that mistake again. Watch videos on this channel right here. Make sure you go car shopping armed with all the information and wisdom you can acquire. If you've seen all the Homework Guy videos and you think you should still go to a dealership and ask, "What can I get approved for?" Well, we're just going to have to ban you from this channel. You just gotta go. No, I'm just kidding. If you learned something today and appreciated the video, consider giving us a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Use hashtag the Homework Guy. Share the video on social media with your friends and family. And make sure to join us on Facebook and Twitter too. We post notifications and other updates on our other social media sites and answer car buyer questions there too. If you love what we do and want to say thanks for the tip, the PayPal and Cash App links you see here will be easy to find in the description box down below. The Homework Guy team has helped millions of car buyers with videos, free contract reviews, market updates, and much more. And we'll always have your back with more great content. Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter. Until next time, take care everyone.